Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. So today I am going to show you how to install latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, that is version 2025.1 on Windows operating system. And after that I will show you how to use IntelliJ IDEA for Java programmings. Now before I start the video, I just wanted to say that I am really sad and angry and depressed with the news in Pahalgam. As you know that about 26 people are just cowardly killed by some terrorist in Pahalgam, Kashmir. So I'm really sad, and one of our very close relative was just killed over there. So I'm really depressed and angry at the same time. I know we crossed 100k subscriber just few weeks back. I wanted to celebrate with you guys, but I just not feeling it right. So I just wanted to share my feelings with you guys. I'm not feeling well. I've been in that place many times. It's really an amazing place to visit. And we call Kashmir just a paradise on earth. So extremely saddened and angry at the same time. I'm really sorry for all this. And I'll try my best to help you installing the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA. So let's dive in into our video. So first is you need to go to your favorite browser, and then you need to open a new tab and just simply type IntelliJ IDEA download and hit enter. So that will show you this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply go to the official site of JetBrains. So this link I'm going to provide right in our channel description. So you need to accept it, and then you need to scroll down and you will get this IntelliJ IDEA community edition. So you need to download that community edition, alright. So just simply click on this download button, and that will show you thank you for downloading IntelliJ IDEA, and it's going to immediately start downloading your IntelliJ IDEA community edition. Remember that. So just cancel this and minimize your browser. Just simply go to your download directory, and you can see my IntelliJ IDEA has already been downloaded over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just simply double click on this installer and going to install it. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes and welcome to IntelliJ IDEA community setup. So let's minimize our download directory and just simply click on next over here. So this is where our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed. So totally fine, just simply click on next over here, and here you need to select all these different options. You need to also select this add bin folder to path. That's a very important step. And now, depending upon what language you'd like to use, you need to select it. I'm going to select Java, as I'm going to use it for Java. And you can also select with Gradle, Groovy, Kotlin. As you know, Kotlin is also very popular among these days. So basically you can select each and everything and just simply click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Just simply hit install, and it's going to immediately start installing our IntelliJ IDEA. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our IntelliJ IDEA community edition is rightly installed. So now it is telling whether you like to reboot your system now or you like to manually reboot later. So I'll always recommend you to reboot your system now. So just simply select that and click on finish to reboot your system. So after restarting your system, let's again come back to this video. So welcome back. So after rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop, and here is our IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup. So just simply double click on this shortcut that's going to launch our IntelliJ IDEA version 2025.1. And there you go. So first it will tell whether you like to import your previous settings from Visual Studio Code. I don't have Visual Studio Code rightly installed. I'm going to start from scratch. So I'm going to just simply click on skip import. So that will open this welcome to IntelliJ IDEA note. You can maximize this and just simply click on new project. So that will open this new project window. Here I need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as hello everyone, and it's going to use this latest version of JDK that I have installed previously. So it's going to use that JDK version 24. If you don't have JDK installed, you can always download it from here. So here is that link, and I'm going to use that installed version of 24, and all other things I'm going to keep it default and just going to simply click on create. So that's going to immediately start creating our Java project. So let's wait for some more time. And there you go. So you can see that that is also rightly done. So our project is rightly opened. So here is our main class, and here is our main method. So within main method, it has already provided one sample code. So it is just going to print hello and welcome note on our console, and then it's going to also print 1 to 5 natural numbers. So if you keep everything as a default and just click on this run button, it's going to immediately start building your project. And once when it gets successfully builded, it's going to show you the output on your console. So first it's going to show you this hello and welcome note, and then it's going to print 1 to 5 natural numbers. So you can see that is rightly doing. So if you wiped out everything that are there within main method and just simply do system.out.println and then hello world, just end with semicolon and just simply click on this run button, it's going to again start building our project. And once when it gets successfully built, it's going to show you the output hello world on your console. So in this way, you can start working on your Java projects on latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, that is version 2025.1. And if you're interested on Python projects, then I have created a playlist just for you guys, so you can watch all these different projects that I've created, and you can apply this, and you can, you know, add all these different projects on your resume as well. So this will help you to learn more in detail about Python programming. So all these project links I'm going to provide right in our channel description. That is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.